Hey guys on YouTube, it's Maddie17 back again. Today I've got for you this Euro washer dryer. It is a Daewoo machine, I believe, that is branded Euro over here. Euro is synonymous with just some sort of budget, I'd say, yeah, budget appliances over here in Australia. Sometimes sold by kitchen fit outs companies and things like that. Yeah, and in sort of budget shops. But yeah, anyway, so it's a Daewoo in drag. 8.5 kilo with a 5 kilo dry capacity on it. It's got an oxy bubble feature and the posi drive. Posi drive, I think, just means the inverter motor. And the oxy bubble is very similar to a Samsung Eco bubble, although it doesn't do as good a job, or as a, or it doesn't create as many bubbles as it, you know, as a Samsung does. Yeah, it's a huge drum, absolutely huge drum. Handles it. I was a bit dubious about this machine because I've read a lot of really bad reviews on these machines, and it came up really cheap secondhand on Marketplace, so I was happy to get it just to try it, and so far it's been pleasantly surprised by how good it handles things. Out of the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 cycles that it's got on the dial, I would probably only use two of them, the cotton normal and the intensive. Oh, I might use synthetic now and again, purely for the fact that there is a lot of limitations. So, like, for example, synthetic doesn't go to 60, and then it goes to 40, which is fine. That's, you know, I probably would use that for normal clothes, smaller loads of clothes. The quick 20 is just a cold wash that runs for 3 minutes and then does the rest of the rinsing and spinning. Tub clean is cold, so that doesn't really do a good job. Sportswear, yeah, I'm not really built for sports, so don't really have a lot of that. The cotton normal cycle is an auto sense cycle, so it'll figure out the weight of the load and adapt it from there. Intensive adds an automatic pre-wash, and we deactivate that if you don't want it. Pretty standard detergent drawer, nothing too exciting there. In terms of options, let's turn this machine on. In terms of options, you've got your wash options there in terms of adding a pre-wash, a soak. Tells you if the child lock and the door lock is on as well. Temps, cold up to 95. 1400 spin, which is good. And then your dry options there. It seems to over dry more than under dry, which, you know, isn't great. I stopped to load the other day because it was just getting too dry and it still had 3 hours left on the dial, on the timer. So it was like, don't know if you've got a great sensor. But anyway, adaptable options, you've got Water Plus, which is an absolutely amazing option. It gives you super high rinses and a very, very, very visible wash level, which you will see today. Delay Start, Memory Cycle, and Rinse Plus. I found that you don't actually need Rinse Plus because it does 3 rinses as standard, which is pretty decent. I'd only do it if I had a really grubby load that I wanted properly rinsed. It's got a nice drum. It does have a jet. It's not the most, it's not a very powerful jet, but it works. It does what it needs to do to soak the top of the load and keep that detergent flowing over the top. Anyway, today we're just going to do a huge load of towels because we find that it can handle that. Elliot put a massive load of his super clean towels in before, and we're going to do it again. So we'll do this. Add this, we're going to use some Dual Mountains Freshness, which I've just bought, and we might add softener. Well, we're going to add softener, I just haven't decided which one yet, so anyway, I'll get this loaded and away we will go. Okay, we are all loaded in. It fit perfectly in that machine, so all is good. Let's get a bit of a wipe. All right, we're going to use a cotton normal cycle. We'll just slip it across to that. Going to use a 95 option, 1400 spin, I'm going to add Water Plus. Don't need Rinse Plus because it does three deep, really deep rinses as it is. And also it does really long in-stream spins as well. So yeah, got normal, 95 degrees, 1400 spin with Water Plus. Let's go. I've added the detergent in. It's all its little sensing tumbles. It's fine. Okay, so you can see that it gives you an awesome initial tumble, initial fill, sorry, with tumble fill. It will top off to this to that higher level again. This is just the soaking, the you know, the soaking tumbles. Just uses that jet to make sure that everything is fully saturated, and then it does a top off. You know, but for a fairly modern machine, this is it's awesome that it actually will use that extra level if you select it. It's perfect for loads like this that just need to be saturated and washed without too much faff. But you can see now that's all wetted down. That's like a 3/4 full load, and that's a lot of towels. There you go, it might need to top off again, who knows. But it really tries to get to that high water level with that water plus selected. And you'll see the rinses are very intense as well, so it's perfect really. The only thing that lets it down, I wouldn't even say let it down, it just can be a bit fussy with balancing sometimes, but that's not, you know, it's nothing too dramatic. Don't stop. Thank you. We're about 18 minutes into the wash or something. We've done one more top off. I missed it because the Jehovah's Witnesses came to the front door. There you go. So we are very much heating. You can hear the heater. 37 already, which is pretty good. It's got a pretty powerful heater on it. I know that the 95 maxes out at about 75. So it's not the worst. Okay, we have finished heating. We made it to about 76, let's say, just to be optimistic. Excuse me, there's 117 left. And you can see that there's more suds, obviously, because the water level has gone up, because the way the water is, when it gets hot, it expands. So it looks like there's a lot of water in there, which there is. Now, I'll let you listen for a minute, but you'll hear the bubble generator, the oxy bubble generator, come on and off occasionally, and it just makes a little noise. So keep an ear out for that. See, with that water plus option, the water level just comes up and up and up. It's amazing. It's great for big grungy loads like this. It's not something I'd use if I was just washing daily clothes, because I'd never wash a big enough load to warrant it. But for these sort of loads, duvets, big blankets, it's perfect. And the fact that it gets up to 77 degrees as well is pretty decent on a 95. I'm used to a lot of modern machines just maxing out at 68, 70 for a 90. I just know there's going to be a suds block. I just know it. Okay, we've just gone into cool down. Well, that was a very brief cool down, and now into interim spin. no sits lock.
That shocked me.
Very long in trim spins. First rinse. I love how it tumble fills, that's a really nice feature. That's a very decent rinse level. There's nothing wrong with that. Love the fact that it tops off as well. Second and trim spin. Second rinse. Nice and clear. Second interim spin before final rinse. Oh, got a slight water lock on the final spin. Third interim spin, sorry. It's weird how it's decided to do it now that the first two have been completely clean. Softener rinse fill. The softener fill takes a lot longer because it does pulse the fill through the drum through the drawer, sorry, so it takes a lot longer to get to that higher level. Spin. So it does a little dip in 7 minutes. And I don't know whether it's trying to decide that it can spin up to 1400 or what. I don't think it's reached 1400, unfortunately. Sometimes it might be limited to 1000 if it's a little bit rattly, but it might still get there. wanted to max out at 1,000 sub loop. But there you go. These things happen. There you go. That was the Euro / Daewoo, model number EWD85FKW. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.